Hi guys, it's Miss Kelly with our kids' message. We've been talking about the way that Jesus tells us to follow him from the book of Luke. I'm going to go further back though and explain how you become a disciple of Jesus Christ. It's simple. All you must do is believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you will be saved, as Paul says in Acts 16:31. I'm going to use a rope and my two lovely assistants to give you an illustration about this. Can Mommy have the rope, please? Thank you. It all starts in Genesis, the first book in the Bible. So in Genesis 1, it says that God created the earth and everything in it, and he did it in 6 days. He created two people, Adam and Eve, and he put them in a beautiful garden. God told them that they could eat from any tree in the garden except one, the tree of knowledge of good and evil. How would you like to only have one rule? That'd be pretty easy to follow, right? Wrong. Adam and Eve gave in to temptation and sinned, just as we all do. Satan comes and tempts us to break the rules and to disobey God, just like he did with Adam and Eve. Go ahead and put your hand in. When we sin, we get all tangled up. The Bible says in the book of Romans that we've all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Our sin separates us from God. The Bible also says that because of that sin, we all deserve to die and to go to hell forever. We can't get rid of this sin on our own, no matter how hard we struggle with it. Go ahead. No! If we die with this sin, then we will spend eternity in hell separated from God. But God doesn't want that. The Bible says that God loves us and wants us to be with him. That's why God sent his only son to die in your place and my place. And if we put our trust in Jesus, he will forgive our sins and give us eternal life. The Bible said that Jesus died on the cross, was buried in the grave for 3 days, and on that third day he rose from the dead, proving that he had power over sin in your life. If you put your trust in Jesus today for the forgiveness of sins, you can know that you will have eternal life with God and that you are a disciple of Jesus. You just need to pray and tell him that you believe. There are no special words to say or a special way to say it. Romans 10:9 says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved.
Brothers and sisters, I want to welcome you back to life, back to the one that can make your next chapter your best chapter. Hallelujah.
How can it be that you love the most unlovable part of me? Of me. How could you see your life was the only gift?
All I wanna do is make you proud of me. That's why
I don't wanna love nobody.
the church sang. Come on. Jesus loving means
more less of me.
That's why.
I don't wanna love nobody but you, nobody but you.
Let me tell you what it does.
He saves the day.
Come on.
He will conquer.
He will let you down, but
all I wanna do is make you proud of me.
Everybody sing.
I don't wanna love nobody but you. I don't wanna love nobody but you.
Yes.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.